What is style? It's a good question. Style is very unique. I think about it as a language, as someone's voice. The tools we use inform the marks we make, and so it's really difficult for me to separate where a tool ends and where an artistic style begins. I'm joining three other equally talented artists and designers, asking what happens to creativity and originality when we teach an AI model to generate in our artistic styles. I wouldn't say I have like one style. I think I have like a kit of tools or like multiple styles that I kind of grab things from. If there's one thing that unites a lot of my work, it's the tension between old and new.
A lot of my personal work is around the sense of nostalgia. My style is very retrofied. I like to keep my work feeling like it lives somewhere in between illustration and photography.
I've always tried to sort of lean into the less realistic, more lo-fi-ness of things. I think the style that I've kind of landed on pays homage to like 80s early digital graphic design. I really like doing strange, eccentric work.
My style is rooted in colors, and I connect that style to childhood a lot. I just want to create visual works that touch people.
I'm scared a little bit of what AI can do. I became an artist and a creative because it's a calling. I like having the idea. I like working on the idea. I like learning new skills. I like pushing myself into new places. I don't want to feel like what I love is being taken away.
AI is in this moment where it's presenting a lot of existential questions to a lot of different professions, but it's not the first time in history where a new piece of technology hugely disrupted an industry. It's not even the first time in art history where this has happened. If you look at the Renaissance, painting kind of felt like graphic design in some ways, where it wasn't really art, it was a service. One of the biggest clients was the Catholic Church. Painting had the responsibility of recording history. When the camera came along, the responsibility shifted to the photograph. Without that responsibility now, painting had just a lot more room to experiment and try new things. I don't think it's a coincidence that abstract expressionism, minimal geometric, more conceptual art emerged only after the camera was invented. When people start being artistic with AI and try to break into new territories, that's where really interesting things start to happen.
When Google first approached me, I was curious. I think it's important for artists to be involved in the creation of AI because it affects us directly. We need to help shape it.
It's hard for a machine to understand what goes into an artistic style. The old way required hundreds of different images, all in the same style. And unless it understands it perfectly, you're probably not going to get the results that you want. But those days are gone. We've been experimenting with this new fine-tuning technique that Google has developed called StyleDrop. I start by taking a few different images that I've created. It's up to me to describe those images and their style. StyleDrop is then able to take those descriptions and image pairings to fine-tune Google's image generation model, Imagen. Once that fine-tuning is complete, I can then generate images of anything that I describe in my own unique style.
Yeah, I would love to see like a hyper-real floral bouquet. Like, what does that look like? Oh my God.
I'll do like a dancing alien. Oh cool, yeah, look at that guy.
Okay, I'm gonna just do something totally random. Yeah. Solar space with planets and comets. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Whoa, okay. A handful of images can generate thousands of AI images in my style. It's kind of crazy.
It's been a process that's been really unlike anything else I've ever worked on.
This is probably the best pixel art AI I've seen.
Using the power of AI to generate so many iterations of my work challenges me to think bigger. Can I create thousands of something? Can I involve people who love my artwork? Can they start generating things?
Together, we're reinterpreting Lewis Carroll's classic, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. The original illustrator, John Tenniel, he only made a small set of images for the story. Those images went on to define the entire visual world of Alice for decades. But the moments that stood out to him, they might not be the ones that stand out to you. What if readers could visualize any scene they wish in a style that resonates with them?
Infinite Wonderland is a generative illustrated novel.
Anybody can take one of the 1,200 sentences within the book and generate an infinite amount of images against it.
Every single person is going to have a completely unique experience. It's almost impossible without StyleDrop.
We're applying our own style to it with the end goal in mind of asking the question, what can AI do and what can artists and designers do with that AI? The line where I begin and where I end is already blurred going into this. It's just another part of a process to make work, but it's still you at the end of the day. It's still your voice. What you're gonna see is probably not gonna be the same as something that I've made by myself. I'm not designing the final piece of it. I'm designing something in the middle of it. In a way, it feels like getting my entire life story and transporting it into a unique paintbrush that I could give to somebody.
My toolkit is forever growing and expanding. I think that's what's so exciting about being an artist.
Artists bring a whole wealth of experiences and influences and skill set that they have built over a lifetime.
Wow, that's really good.
That's really nice.
No matter how AI progresses, I will always want to create work.
You know, they say that the best way to learn a new concept is to teach it. Through this process of teaching an AI model my own style, I've learned a lot about it. I've learned what makes it unique, but also where I myself might evolve.